We do have another guest that we will be speaking to on Skype from the other side of the world out in Europe. It's a man who most recently, of course, coached the Nigerian national team, Sunday Olise. He, of course, amongst that great golden generation, will be joining us. And Sunday, the last time we spoke to you, it was a serious matter, but it's completely different this time around. We celebrate, we like to say, whilst we also take some time to mourn a, like yourself and many others on this continent, man that's done so much for the Nigerian and African game. Thank you for joining us, by the way.
Well, thanks for having me.
Yes, thank you. Let's talk about Stephen Keshi. You played against, you played alongside him, I should say, and of course, a part of that great generation. We spoke to Daniel Amokachi earlier on as well. Tell us about your memories and what you would have taken from your encounters and being alongside him in the trenches.
Well, like P, that was saying, you know, Steve was a, he was just a leader. It was kind of like he was born to lead. And it's like, I can't remember Steve staying behind. And I think that's what's special about him. As a player, he was also a pioneer because he was the first Nigerian player to really become professional in Belgium with Locker and then. And that kind of like paved the way for others to follow through, myself included. That was way by the 90s, whereby we had very few blacks in Europe. So it's so sad that he's gone.
Now, you've also followed the same paths as players together. Yeah, you've also coached together. There are not very many that will have had success as a player, as a coach, anywhere in the world, on any continent, whether it be Europe or South America, Asia, and including this continent. His contribution to, well, the way it should be done in those that dedicate their lives to this game.
Well, I think as regards the coaching aspect, Steve is probably the only successful Nigerian coach we have. Because I think if you're going to talk of success, you talk about winning titles.
Yeah.
And it's the only Nigerian coach that has won a title. For that reason, I think he's gone into the history of books as the best coach we have till date. And as a human being, he was generous. You know, people look at the side of, I've heard some dirty comments in the past, but they don't know this man. Like, he knows him. He's played with him. I played with him, and he was my captain. He later became my coach when I became captain, you know, eventually. And it's so sad, really. It's yesterday, I was, the whole thing was bad for me, the whole day yesterday.
Sunday, it's TK. I know football is a very emotional game for that matter. And have you ever once or twice, whatever, during the heat of the moment, have you ever clashed with him because he's such a winner in the field?
Well, I was one of his protected members of the team.
Lucky you.
Yeah, because I played in front of him, so I did all the mopping up. So for that, and I must be honest with you, he taught me how to lead. Mm. Because when I became a captain, I remember he called me into his room. Then he was assistant coach. And then he really made it clear to me so many things, that this is how it goes and all that. And when you watch Steve was the type like, okay, he had his generals, great. But one thing about Steve was that if we were owed money, he was the first one that said, no. And you know, with Nigeria, it happens on the daily. So that means, you know, and the thing is that you get labeled a bad name when you're fighting for the group.
Yeah.
I personally went through that also. But it's a sacrifice you have to pay if you want to lead Nigeria.
Yeah.
Whether you like it or not, if you're going to be a leader of the players, you must be a rebel. And that's what Steve was.
Good way.
That's what Steve was. Because look, the story P was telling you earlier on, he wasn't lying.
Yes. He was there. Sonny was there. Mm.
He wasn't lying. These are things that happened. And these are things you have to do. And I had to do it. Eventually, it became so bad during my generation where I had to spend personal money. But then, because I was blessed in a different way. Mm-hmm. But it gets to a point, you say, no, enough is enough. And Steve, we should build, like, it's monumental what he did for Nigerian football.
Now, let's talk about the influence, the same influence. When you look at it from an African coaching point of view, whereas so many countries on this continent will employ a European coach, and the feeling amongst many is they get the cream de la cream of treatment from the various FAs. Now, in putting up the fight for an African successful, we have to also mention that successful, as you did say, a coach. I mean, you look at the fact that he qualified for Togo with the World Cup. Didn't go with Togo. Yeah. He opted for a man from beyond the borders of Africa. The fight he put up as a coach, the example he set for African coaches in reaching for the skies. What do you think?
Well, the excuse initially used to be we're not qualified as Africans. Well, that excuse has gone out of the way now. Because I'm a UEFA pro licensed coach. I hold the same degree like Guardiola and others hold. Mm-hmm. And Sean Bartlett back home in South Africa. Mm-hmm. I'm aware he's also on the path of getting the UEFA professional coaches license, mm-hmm. which is the highest in the world. So the question of is not that an excuse, but it's just the question is that we refuse to decolonize ourselves. That is the thing. Because the reality is that when you are an African, it's almost impossible to get a coaching job in Europe.
Yes.
It's almost impossible. Because if I was to send you my CV now, you would shout, wow. But the thing there is that when you bring it here, I've had presidents in Europe say to me, and they did it to Keshi, because one of Keshi's agents who tried to get him to coach in Europe told me that also. They did it to Keshi also when they tried to get him a job in Europe, and they'll say, but what do we expect for our people that we took an African coach when we had Africa? Wow. But why don't Africans do the same?
Wow. Yeah.
This is a man who has qualified. Look, you are saying Keshi qualified Togo and Nigeria for the World Cup. You are wrong. Keshi helped qualify Nigeria for the World Cup twice.
Twice. Yeah.
I think Bill told us the same thing.
Because he was assistant coach when I was captain, and we qualified Nigeria for 2002 World Cup.
Yeah.
And he was sacked, and they didn't allow him to go to that World Cup. Yeah. Only to eventually install a certain Onigbinde, who went there and we had the worst result of the World Cup Nigeria has ever had. And at the time where this man has died now, it is so painful because I had a very bad day yesterday. My wife thought I was going to be sick. Sure. Because I was saying to myself, I was hearing people praising him, and I said, look, this is a man that was chastised, criticized, if eventually pushed out of the national team, humiliated twice. And not thanked. And now that he's dead, the same people are coming out to say, why did you say it when he was alive? So that he could at least enjoy it. So that his family can enjoy it with him. And we do it now. Look, Africa is ours. We should be priority. As an African, you shouldn't be second fiddle to anybody else in Africa. And the moment if we don't learn it, we'll never get better.
Sonny, let me ask a question. I see your emotions there. It's very painful. We all feel this knowing that we've lost a legend and a brother. How do you think Keshi can be honored? You know, what do you think the government should do? You know, I think he has to be honored. He has to be
remembered.
Really honored. I say as a people. What's your opinion?
Well, the first thing we can do is that personally, I think we should name a national something after him.
Yeah.
You know, it's like when you go by Europe, you see players that, with all due respect, did not achieve half of what African players achieve. And they have like sports centers named after them. Now, Yekini went 4 years ago. Just recently, we had to talk about the anniversary of his death. Could you believe that even some national newspapers not even talk about it back home? You know, nobody started it. So what is wrong with naming the stadium in Abuja or something, or in Lagos, or in somewhere after Stephen Keshi? At least you give the youths, you know, this way Keshi will always be remembered. And you also give the youths an opportunity to say, look, if you serve Nigeria, look at what can happen to your family and yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wise words indeed.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I don't think you could have put it any better than that, Sunday. And thank you very much for your time and for helping us celebrate a really great African, a great man, a great contributor to the African game. And, well, again, our thoughts are very much with you and the entire Nigerian football fraternity. All of Africa is with you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sunday.
There you have it now.